He didn't know about this. It's not happy yet. It's, I won't keep it too long, so I'm going to keep this really short. I will try and be funny in parts, and I'll keep it really close friendly, just like my buddy Jim here. So, I think firstly, I just want to say I'm really impressed by how many people have arrived here today. So we've got people coming from England.
Having to handle such a big one. And we also spent numerous nights in the infamous Inferno's nightclub, just not the case for the show. Fucking
Dude, run! Alright, so you've heard about how we became friends. I thought I'd do some research into what happened to the guys Jim left behind. So those guys, so one of them, I believe, is running a tech startup. One of them's a full-time stand-up comedian. One of them's a touring musician. And the other one is a political activist. So I'm lucky, mate, with you today. You've got a risk out of this. There's a couple of accounts running today, so I don't know if I'm having a pie. So it's a relay. At least the language barrier is going to help us tomorrow when we subject you our guest to our terrible chat. And just to be clear, Scottish absolutely counts in a different language. Leading off from that, one thing we never understood about Jim is what happened to him every time he went back to the family home after school. So Jim during school would very much have an English accent. I don't know if you can do it for us now.
Hi, my name's Jim.
It was really confusing. So if you're speaking to Jim and his parents, he'd go switch between accents all the time. It was, yeah, ridiculous to follow. He finally made the transformation to being the full proud Scot yesterday. I believe it was after his final A-level exam. And I'm sure tomorrow, when he's in his kill, there'll be some curiosity about whether he really is that true Scot. I have to say, there's not a lot to be curious about. This transformation is he made Jim 10 times cooler. Well, that has to be the bar's pretty low to start with. One benefit of this is there's good practice of being bilingual prior to manhood. You've got no excuse to make for not being fluent in Spanish already. So. Unsurprisingly, a lot of our friendship has been based around going out, having a few too many beers. So I thought I'd give you some examples of what makes Jim such a fantastic drunk. I can't be too harsh because, well, I'd like to be too harsh because his dad's in the crowd, he'd be really proud.
Go on, tell me. Hello, mate.
Can't be too harsh. So, just going to go for some examples. After a lifelong allergy, he first discovered he was no longer allergic to shellfish when he tucked into a pile of crimp truck. He's jumped into bed with his brother-in-law, John. Where is John? He's got his pets. I don't know. Yeah, you need to ask for that. I don't have any more details about that. He's very close to his chest. He would also speak up though, with us quite recently, but he only managed to have to see 0 days of skiing because he was too hungover to get hard of anything. He sometimes returns back to the English accent, so he's already done that tonight, so definitely say he's quite drunk already. And he's got a fantastic knack of making me look a lot more sober than last year. There is one main benefit of Jim's drinking. I've witnessed this quite recently at Jim, when I visited Jim in Poland. His Polish becomes a lot more fluid. So, it's not all bad. Most of you will know that Andy and Jim first met in the workplace. And as Jim's career has obviously means a lot to him, he's moved down to Poland in pursuit of more challenging and rewarding work. And it's time to ask some of Jim's work colleagues what he's like to work with. And surprisingly, he's described him as somewhat ugly. As he's never there, and when he does any work, he's a bloody miracle. I also asked Andrea what her favourite memories were when working for Jim. So you probably know that Jim was her analyst manager briefly. And I asked that here if there's anything she missed. I was shocked when she quickly responded to tell me that she really missed the additional benefits that she managed to get. Supposedly the private healthcare and pension scheme were really great. So it really is impossible to praise him too highly. In fact, while writing this speech, I found it almost impossible to praise him at all. However, there are some pleasant jokes I do admire. The first one really stands out. Hey, yes, this is my favorite. The first one really stands out is his ability to remain cool in most circumstances. For example, when I'm on holiday with Jim in Barcelona, only an hour after arrival, while making our way to the apartment, he was completely covered by a local entering their tobacco spitting from a fourth floor window. It was honestly the most disgusting thing I've ever seen in my life. That's horrible. But Jim, being Jim, he liked it. He pretended like nothing happened. And he really took that one on the chin. And on the head. And a little bit in the mouth as well. Another one of Jim's traits, which bodes well for him and Andy's financial future, is that he doesn't like to waste money. He's always looking for a deal to a way to save money, even when breaking up with his girlfriends. One time, knowing their relationship wasn't going any further, Jim was keen to avoid investing any more money than he had to. So decided there's less place to part ways with his local web skins. So Jim flew to Poland, sorry, I greatly respect, as he definitely has proven to be, he needed to seize opportunities when they present themselves to him. After what was initially only a 6-month contract, a couple of years later in Poland, he's got a job he really enjoys. A great flat, great new friends, they're alright, I'm enjoying it. And most importantly, he's found someone he wants to spend the rest of his life with. You can even say I look up to him, but... Jokes aside, it's good to see that he's extremely happy that he's settled so well in Poland. I believe he already considers Krakow more of a home than he ever considered London. And long may this continue. So, this is it. This is the end of my speech, so I'm not. So, will you please read the class? I think I've got it.
Cheers. Proszę Państwa, nie pijemy do dna. Ja coś teraz powiem, będzie musiało to być przetłumaczone. Jeżeli ktoś potrafi zgrabnie to zrobić, to zapraszamy. Otóż szampon jest nieco gorzkawy. The champagne is not sweet.
Gorzki szampan, gorzki szampan, nie będziemy pili. Chcemy, żeby Państwo młodzi szampan osłodzili.
Sprawdzamy, czy jest słodki. Now is sweet. It's better not enough. Więc jedziemy dalej, drodzy Państwo.
Oni te mówili, oni te mówili. Oni temu winni, oni temu winni. Pocałować się powinni.
Try now, spróbujcie, drodzy Państwo, teraz. Ja myślę, że powinien, na tę chwilę powinien być już bardzo słodki. I taki jest, drodzy Państwo, pijemy do dna za zdrowie i szczęście młodych. Drodzy Państwo, na zdrowie Ani i Jima. To było, drodzy Państwo, teraz wielkie oklaski. Brawo, brawo dla młodych. Kochani, a teraz zapraszam już do życzeń. Zapraszamy do życzeń i dziękujemy na tę chwilę.
So do bear with me. But I'd like to welcome everyone first of all and just thank you for coming on our special day. And we do really, really appreciate it. I think you can see we've got a real international presence here. We've obviously got a Polish contingent, we've got people from Scotland, yeah. We've got people from England, yeah. We've got Ireland, Australia, Egypt, Italy, and even Lithuania as well. Witamy wszystkich. Przede wszystkim dziękuję Wam za przybycie. Mamy międzynarodową reputację gości z Polski, Szkocja, Anglii, Irlandii, Australii, Włoch, Egiptu i Litwy. So, guys, on each of your table, you'll see there's a menu for of the food that we serve and also a schedule of the day. And there'll be a few surprises along the way as well. And that's both in English and in Polish. Na każdym stole macie menu i plan dnia z kilkami, kilkoma niespodziankami. So firstly, from me, I really want to thank Anya's family, both here in Krosno and in Warsaw. They've made me really, really feel welcome, and I already feel part of the family already. I'd also like to thank my two best men, John and Stephen. They've been a really, really great help, and they organised a fantastic SAG in Edinburgh, but I don't think I'm going to say too much about that. Okay, chcę podziękować Ani Rodzina za bycie tak serdecznym, zarówno w Krośnie, jak i Warszawie. Już dawno czuję, że część rodziny. Chcę podziękować moim dwóm przyjaciołom, Stephen i John, którzy bardzo mi pomogli i zorganizowali wieczór kawalerski w Edynburgu. So, I guess what I wanted to say for me was, I moved to Poland about 3 years ago, and I'll be completely honest, I never expected you actually stood here today. However, a little someone sat next to me changed that forever, and I really want to thank Anya for that. You've basically made a Scottish man find his way. And I think we'll all agree that Anya looks absolutely beautiful today. Kiedy przeprowadziłem się do Polski 3 lata temu, nie myślałem, że będę stać teraz tutaj. Ale ta oto osoba brzmiła całe moje życie. Ania, dziękuję. Nie jesteś jedynie moją żoną, ale również najlepszym przyjacielem. Pomogłaś mi odnaleźć swoją drogą. Ania, wyglądasz pięknie dzisiaj. Last but not least, we'd actually like to both thank our wonderful parents, because without them, we wouldn't be here today. So, on behalf of myself and Anya, we want to thank both of them. I've got a couple of gifts to show our appreciation. Popolsko. Nie bylibyśmy tutaj dzisiaj, gdyby na nasi wspaniali rodzice. Oboje chcemy bardzo wam podziękować za wszystko, co dla nas robicie. So, if both sets of parents can't do.
Zapraszamy rodziców.
Right, yeah. Oh, sorry, so.
Anya, be together always, when times are good, but also when times are bad. Love and support each other. I am pleased to see so many guests taking part in such an important day for the new viewers. I wish you both a wonderful time and good luck. I'd like to propose a toast to the happy couple.
Thank you. So hot that I melted, I fell right through the cracks. Now I'm trying to get back before the cool done run out. I'll be giving it my best. It's nothing that's gonna stop me, but divine intervention. I'm going to be my turn to win some or learn some. But I won't hesitate no more. This is all.
Walking over dress, wearing buckets of stale cologne. So hard to see streets on a country road when your glass is in the garbage and your continental's just been towed. We're gonna take your mama out all night, yeah, we'll show her what it's all about. We'll get her jacked up on some cheap champagne, we'll let the good times all roll out. And if the music ain't good, well, it's just too bad. We're gonna sing along no matter what, because the dancers don't mind at the New Orleans if you tip them and they make a cut. Do it! Take your mama out all night, so she'll have no doubt that we're doing all the best we can. Gonna do it! Take your mama out all night, you can stay up late, cause baby you're a full-grown man.
This has not been half stressful, my goodness. Are we all having a good time? Yeah! Capitale!
London!
Yeah! Oh, that was quiet, we'll try that one more time. Are we all having a good time? Yeah! Third time lucky. Okay, so. So, it's an interesting one. I know you don't usually do speeches here in Poland, but I've been waiting for 24 years to do this, and I thought it would not be right to let Jim have his wedding day without embarrassing him just a wee bit.
I need translate. Zgodnie ze środkiem zwyczajem wymagane jest, by grupa wygłosić na weselowę. Wiem, że nie należy to do polskiej tradycji, jednakże czekałem, Steven czekał, na tę chwilę całe 24 lat. Więc zdecydowanie nie mogłem teraz odebrać sobie przyjemności i zamieść Dima, nie podejmując choćby najmniejszej próby zawstydzenia go na forum rodziny. Przy okazji zwracając kilka tej.
There we are. Well, I'm sure we're all been having a great day. I'm going to hand the microphone back to this idiot. Okay, so I'm sure we've all been having a great day and making it one to remember. Unlike Jim at his sister's wedding, where he made it one to forget.
Jestem pewny, że ten wspaniały dzień na długo pozostanie w pamięci na wszystkich. Miejmy jednak nadzieję, że z tych właściwych powodów. Chciałbym przypomnieć, iż to właśnie Jim zdołał uczynić ślub własnej siostry niezapomnianym przeżyciem. Lecz zgoła z odmiennych przyczyn, o których chyba wszyscy woleliby zapomnieć.
Czy to mówić po angielsku? So, now knowing Jim as we do, it's clear that Anya will make the perfect wife for him. Now bear with me, I've got some props here. Jim can't wait. Anya is going to make the perfect light wife. Now we all know that Jim loves to eat. Which is perfect because Anya is a great chef. Here we are, Anya, there's your hat.
Dla osoby znającej Jima tak dobrze jak ja, oczywistym staje się fakt, iż Anya stanowi idealne jego dopełnienie i na pewno będzie wspaniałą żoną. Dlaczego? Po pierwsze, najważniejsze, Anya fantastycznie gotuje. Jak wiemy, Jim wprost uwielbia jeść.
Now he's my brother, and I love him. But Jim is very lazy and very, very messy. But that's okay, because Anya loves to clean.
Kocham Jima, kończy to mój brat. Ale wszyscy dobrze wiemy, że Jim jest leniwy i ma ograniczenie miara. Co prawda, nie powinno to stanowić więcej niż problemu, gdyż Anya bardzo lubi siądać.
Now, Anya clearly has many attributes to the perfect wife, but there's one that she maybe hadn't anticipated, and I think that because it's her wedding day, that now is the appropriate moment to share this. Anna, stop that! Stop that!
What?
Ah, come on now, that's filth. No, no, no. Jim loves a trip to the hospital. So Anya has to be ready to look after him.
Anya zdecydowanie posiada wiele cech dobrej żony. Wśród nich jedna, może nie oczywista, niż mówiąca automatycznie za głowy, ale niezwykle ważna. Można by rzec, niezbędna. Myślę, iż dzień ślubu to dobry moment, aby zdradzić wam pewien sekret. Otóż okoliczności często zmuszają Jima do odwiedzin szpitali. Więc Anya chcąc nie chcąc musi umieć dobrze się do mnie kochać.
Now it's not all about Anya doing stuff for Jim. And Jim is also going to contribute to this marriage. And they'll be able to share a lot of things. One thing in particular that they'll be able to share is shoes. And why is that? Because, like Anya, Jim is also a size 6.
Tak, Anya robi bardzo dużo dla Jima, ale zakładam, iż Jim także wnosi coś wartościowego do ich związku. Na przykład wśród rzeczy, które spokojnie mogą ze sobą dzielić, to buty. Gdyż tak się składa, że oboje noszą rozmiar 39.
Yes, it is. Now I knew that the first time Anya made us a hungover lunch that she was the right woman for Jim. She then got in the habit of making Jim his lunch at work. And being his father's son, Jim thought that this was the best thing ever. And it wasn't long before she was moving in with him. In sin.
Już od dnia, w którym Anya po raz pierwszy zaserwowała nam posiłek, co tu kryć, na wyleczenie kaca, wiedziałem, że jest to właściwą dla Jima. W pewnym momencie ta urocza kobieta wypracowała w sobie nawet nawyk przygotowywania Jimowi przekąsek do pracy. Jak to mówią, niedaleko pada jabłko od jabłoni, więc Jim, dokładnie tak samo jak ojciec, stwierdził, że lepiej już nie można trafić. Stąd wkrótce potem Anya wprowadziła się do Jima i odtąd żyli już razem. Tak, podkreślmy to, żyli w grzechu.
Now to make a good impression, Jim decided to learn Polish to impress this lovely girl. He caught on very quickly with some aspects of the language. He progressed from Piwo dziękuję to Dwa piwa proszę. And he went from Czechowicz Pangielsko to Katz Vegas.
Żeby wywrzeć dobre wrażenie, czy też zaimponować Ani, Jim postanowił nauczyć się polskiego. Bardzo szybko przyswoił kilka konkretnych wyrażeń. I równie szybko zaczął robić postępy, by wkrótce być w stanie powiedzieć: dwa piwa proszę, zamiast piwo dziękuję. Albo o nie, Las Vegas, zamiast ty mówisz po angielsku.
But there is also Jim's favorite line. This one isn't even in Polish. Anya, I'm really hungry.
I oczywiście Jim ma ulubione. Anya, jestem głodny. Podaj coś do jedzenia.
Now, it would be unfair to make a speech here without mentioning the other love in Jim's life. Football.
Było Byłoby grzechem nie wspomnieć na ślubie trzymałej o drodze miłości, piłce nożnej.
Now Jim, I can get rid of that, there we go. When Jim and Anya began courting, it was like Jim was a kid again. Mum would be asking how things were with her, and all he could say was, oh, it's amazing, it's lovely, it's lovely, but she's amazing, but guess what? She loves football. Jim thought he had hit the jackpot.
Kiedy Jim i Anya dopiero zaczynali się spotykać, mój ukochany brat zachowywał się co najmniej dziwnie, właściwie jak dziecko. Za każdym razem, gdy mama starała się powiedzieć czegoś na temat jego nowej dziewczyny, wszystko co Jim był w stanie w siebie wydusić, to jest dobrze, ona jest super, jest kapitalna, lubi futbol, piłkę nożną. Według Jima to najlepsza cecha, jaką tylko może mieć kobieta.
As time went on though, Jim seemed to become a bit less enthusiastic about his sporting days out with Anya. He seemed so excited about going go-karting with her, but then nothing.
Po jakimś czasie Jim jednak jakby stracił początkowy entuzjazm. Powiedziałbym od momentu, kiedy zaczęli jeździć na go-kartach. A trzeba podkreślić, że na początku już sam pomysł jazdy na go-kartach, by tam pójść, wprowadzał go w niezłą euforię.
And as his brother, you know, I was becoming a wee bit worried. I was thinking, God, I hope everything's okay between them. But then I discovered the truth for Jim being so quiet. Anya kept winning.
We've been through. Jako brat zacząłem się martwić, że coś poszło nie tak, jak trzeba. Ale wkrótce dano mi było odkryć zaskakującą prawdę. Dzień po prostu był przygnębiony, gdyż Ania cały czas nie wygrywała. A tego już jego ego ścierpieć nie mogło i wolał przemilczeć prawdę.
And the funny thing is that this had never happened to Jim before, and he didn't know how to cope. But rather than put him off, I actually think this made it, I think it made him feel more keen. But some might call this love, but knowing Jim as we do, I think he's just waiting to try and get his own back. But knowing Anya as we do, he's going to be waiting a very, very long time.
Nigdy wcześniej nic takiego nie miał miejsca przed Jima, więc biedak po prostu nie wiedział, jak się zachować. Ale tak naprawdę ta cała historia zamiast zniechęci go do Ani, ostatecznie raczej jeszcze bardziej go zachęciła. Niektórzy nazwaliby to miłością. Ale znając mojego brata, uważam, że trwając w boku Ani, czekał tylko na kolejną kolej, by się odegrać. Natomiast znając Anię, powiedziałbym, że jeszcze długo może sobie tak czekać. Ania i tak zawsze będzie z nim wygrywać.
Now, bowling is another sport that Jim has become very, very competitive at. And during my recent visit to Poland, we went for a game.
Innym sportem, w którym Jim próbuje współzawodzić z Anią, są kręgle. Podczas jednej z moich wizyty w Polsce poszliśmy zagrać. Co to była za gra?
Now this was not just Słowiki contra Lafferty. This was not Anthony versus Jim. No, no, this was something much, much, much bigger. This was Scotland versus Poland. They won. And not for the first time. It was here, on their home ground, annoyingly. Not for the first time, Jim was resenting me as his wee brother for having let his side down again.
To nie chodziło o zwykłą rozgrywkę między Słowikami a rodziną Laferty. To nie był zwykły pojedynek między Antonim i Anią, a Jimem i Stevenem. O nie, wszystko urosło do rangi międzynarodowego spotkania na szczycie. To był prawdziwy mecz, Szkocja kontra Polska. Ostatecznie Polska oczywiście wygrała. I oczywiście nie pierwszy raz Jim obarczył mnie, swojego młodszego brata, winą za poniesioną klęskę.
Now I first visited Krosno, came here a few months ago, And when I met Anya's family, I was greeted with such warmth. A lot of food and a set of slippers. But after spending only a couple of days there, I knew that while on the one hand, you know, we're sad to lose him, but we know that he's going to be joining a very kind and loving family.
Pierwszy raz zawitałem w Krośnie kilka miesięcy temu. I muszę powiedzieć, że rodzina Ani powitała mnie z otwartymi ramionami, miłością, mnóstwem jedzenia i parą kapci. Już kilka dni spędzonych w ich towarzystwie w zupełności wystarczyło, by zrozumieć, że może i owszem, my tracimy Jima, ale za to Jim zyskuje w zamian nową, wspaniałą, kochającą rodzinę.
So I'd like to thank everyone for coming along to making this day so, so wonderful. And I'd especially like to thank the British Embassy for managing to sort out that minor hiccup with Jim's marital status. Now hopefully this won't affect his ability to get a Polish passport, because due to recent events in the UK, it looks like he might be needing one.
Chciałbym podziękować wszystkim za przybycie i uczynienie tego dnia tak wyjątkowym. Chciałbym również podziękować ambasadzie brytyjskiej za sprawne rozwiązanie problemu określenia stanu cywilnego Jima. Bo nie wiem, czy wszyscy wiedzą, ale przy pierwszych dokumentach było wpisane, że wcale nie jest single. To jest pomyłka. Także dlatego. Mam nadzieję, iż taka drobnostka nie wpłynie negatywnie na możliwość otrzymania przez zainteresowanego w najbliższym przyszłości polskiego paszportu. A biorąc pod uwagę ostatnie wydarzenia w Wielkiej Brytanii, na pewno takowy mu się przyda.
So here we are. I'd like you to be all upstanding, as is our tradition, and propose a toast to the bride and groom.
Proszę wszystkich o powstanie. Chciałbym przysłać za Państwa młody.
Na zdrowie!
Na zdrowie!
100 lat, 100 lat, niech żyją się nam. 100 lat, 100 lat, niech żyją się nam. Jeszcze raz, niech żyją się nam. Niech żyją nam. 100 lat, 100 lat, 100 lat, 100 lat.
Jest na pewno słodka ta wódka.
Choć z pewnością nie będę taki zabawny jak Steven.
So in Poland, it's not such a tradition as Scotland to do speeches, but Kuba also wants to say something about the newlyweds. Not only because he's only got the one twin sister, but he doesn't get another chance at this. So we're going to try not to bore you, and Kuba says he will not be as funny as Stephen, but it's not really, it's going to be easy, mate, trust me.
Co mogę powiedzieć o mojej siostrze w tym wspaniałym dniu? Zawsze była ambitna, podchodziła do wszystkiego na 100%. Świadectwo z Paskiem to była dla niej konieczność. Podczas gdy ja imprezowałem w gimnazjum przy liceum, ona szkoliła język angielski, odrabiała dodatkowe zadania dla chętnych i robiła wszystko, by wejść w dorosłość z odpowiednim przygotowaniem. W szkole grała czołowe role we wszystkich organizowanych przedsięwzięciach. Za pierwszym razem zdała egzamin na prawo jazdy, ja zdałem się na drugim i skończyłam prawo.
So what can Kuba, I mean, it says what can I say about my sister, but that was about 5 years ago. So what can he say about his sister on this wonderful day? Well, she was always ambitious. She did everything 100%. And getting a first in her degree, that was a necessity for Anya. It does not surprise me. While Kuba was partying in high school, Anya was learning and practicing English. She was doing extra homework. And she went into adulthood with the appropriate preparation. In school, she had all the lead roles in every project, and she passed her driving test first time. That's first time, Jim. Unlucky. And she went on to study law at university.
Anya była przy tym wszystkim niezwykle grzeczna, spokojna i uprzejma. Zawsze zachowywała zdrowy rozsądek i podchodziła do wszystkiego z głową. Przeciwnie niż ja, często lądowałem albo na niewolniku w szkole, albo w szpitalu z kolejną kontuzją.
She was always extremely kind, calm and polite. She always maintained a healthy sense of humour. She approached everything with her head. Unlike Kuba, who just landed on the red carpet in school or in hospital with another injury.
You know it, Stephen. Thank you. Zawsze była bardzo aktywna, uprawiała sport, pływała na basenie, grała w piłkę nożną, jeździła na rowerze. Zapałem oglądała mecze Manchesteru United i całymi nocami, nie dając mi spać po nocach, zdychała do Davida Beckhama.
So Anya, she was always very active, she always played sports, she swam, played football, rode the bike. She watched Man United with great love, and she sat up all night sighing to David Beckham, which kept Kuba up all night.
Troszczyła się o mnie, bała, bym zawsze miał odrobione zadanie w szkole. Zgłaszała się do odpowiedzi, wiedząc, że nie jestem nieprzygotowany. Dzięki temu ratowała mnie w potrzebie, na przykład na lekcjach języka niemieckiego w gimnazjum.
So she always cared about Kuba, and because of her, he made up for the homework because she gave him the answers, knowing that he hadn't done it. And thus, she saved him in many times of need. For example, there was many lessons of German in junior high school.
Bałabym w zbyt młodym wieku nie popełniał głupstw. Była przy tym może czasem ostra. Po jej reakcji bałem się wracając z imprez w liceum. To gdy ona po mnie przyjeżdżała samochodem po wyjściach na miasto, siedziałem w nim jak trusia, słuchając wywodów, jak ja wyglądam, co ze mnie wyrośnie.
So when they were younger, Anya always wanted Kuba to be a good child and not do stupid things. Sometimes she did get annoyed at him. Many times he was afraid of her reaction when she was picking up after a party from school, because Kuba was sitting scared and drunk in the car, listening to her going on and on at him, and she was how he looked and asking, "What will you be like in the future?" We've all heard that, Anya.
Życzę i jestem tego pewien, że własne dzieci wychowa również z taką samą troską i starannością, jak wychowała mnie.
So I wish and I'm sure that Anya will raise her children with the same care and diligence that she's raised Cuba.
Podczasy między nami iskrzy, już w duchu mamy z nią wytrzymywałem, wykopałem ją z niego na miesiąc przed terminem porodu. Nigdy nie wyobrażałem sobie mieć inne siostry, jestem za nią wdzięczny Bogu.
So although they have different characteristics, and they sometimes argue, and in brackets here it says, during mum's pregnancy, Cuba couldn't stand her and kicked her out 1 month early. But then he could never imagine to have another sister. He couldn't imagine having another sister, and he's very grateful to God that he does have her.
I tego ja się traktuję, wspierał pieniądze, przestaje ze sobą utrzymywać kontakty. Jestem pewny, że na to nie grozi. I zawsze wraz z naszymi rodzinami będziemy utrzymywać ze sobą kontakt bliski, a nasze dzieci będą razem do nas.
So we've heard a lot of different stories about siblings and how they treat each other, they argue about money, they don't want to keep in touch. I'm sure that Cuba and Anya are not in danger of this, and our families will always keep in close contact, and our children will grow up together.
Something about this. That's a good thing. We should come to the moment later. Pójdźcie sobie na dwołaczki. Dima poznałem w Krakowie podczas mojej nowej wizji mojej siostry, w tym pięknym miejscu, w którym również spędziłem 2 lata z mojego życia. Dzień był Ani kolegą z pracy, który poopiekowała się, pomagała od początku jego pobytu w Krakowie, jakoś potrzebował pomocy w kwestiach logistycznych oraz organizacyjnych. Czy to na trzeźwo, czy podczas nocnej powrotu z miasta. Nie pozwalał nam w spokoju spędzić razem weekendu, gdyż to już potrzebował pomocy. Był przy tym bardzo uprzejmy, miły i wychowany. W związku z czym nie miałem nic przeciwko jemu.
So Cuba of course met Jim in Krakow during one of his routine visits to his sister in the beautiful city. And he also spent 2 years of his life there. Jim was Anya's colleague from work. Who he cared for. We all know that one. Who cared for him and helped him from the beginning of his stay in Krakow. Because Jim needed a lot of help and organisation, whether he was awake or during the night and returning from the city. He wouldn't leave Cuba and Anya in peace to spend any time together on the weekends, because once again, he needed help. But he was always very polite, kind and good manners, and therefore Cuba didn't have anything against him.
Szybko zauważyłem, iż może to nie być tylko przyjaźń, choć Ania, ma kochana siostra, się tego bardzo wypierała. Dzień był świeżo po rozstaniu, Ania również. Oboje ich dość związków potrzebowali czasu na zdecydowanie się po tych starych. Widać było, że to tylko kwestia czasu, że coś z tego może być. Pomimo iż oboje stwierdzili, że to tylko przyjaźń. Dzień ma wyraźnie do Ani ciągnęło. Ania czuła się przy nim nie mniej swobodnie, jak przy mnie sam.
So Cuba noticed quickly that there was something more than just friends. But Anya told him that he was just talking nonsense. Jim was just after a breakup. And so was Anya. See what I mean? But both had enough of relationships and needed a bit of time to reset. It was evident though. That it was only a matter of time and that something could change quickly. And even though they both claimed it was only friendship. Aye, right. Jim was clearly drawn to Anya. And Anya... well, Anya was drawn to Jim as well.
Jim's czyni tak samo jak ja uwielbia rywalizację. Oczywiście, jak wygrywa. Dlatego dobrze razem się bawimy, rywalizując ze sobą, czy to na torze do kręgi, czy grając w bilar, czy na torze do kartowe. I choć jestem czasem na niego zły, bo kolejny z robotań oraz z bilar, to jednak nie da się na niego głównie jebać.
So Jim loved competition as much as Kuba, of course, when he wins. So they had a lot of fun competing with each other, whether it's bowling or playing pool or the go-karts. And although sometimes Kuba is angry at him after another shameful defeat at pool, he can't be angry with him for a very long time.
Choć do dniu Jima, rodziców i brata oraz siostrę poznałem dopiero przed weselem. To z licznych relacji, opowieści, zdjęć oraz filmów wiem, jak niezwykli są to ludzie. A ciepło bijące od nich ogrzewa szkockie deszczowe wieczory, docierając do Krakowa, Krosna i Warszawy. Dziękuję wam, że Ania przy was czuje się jak w drugim domu. Ze Stevenem interesuje kryteria w Krakowie, bawi się z Katie, prowadzi dyskuty za Mangą. A z mamą Jima tak dużo się kontaktuje i rozmawia, że sam Jim twierdzi, że ta więcej czasu poświęca jej niż jemu i jest o to zazdrosny.
So although Kuba only met Jim's family, his parents, his brother and his sister just before the wedding, he's heard from many stories, photos and videos, and he knows how amazing they are. Oh, thanks. He knows how amazing they all are. And the heat radiating from the Scottish rainy evenings reaches up to Krakow, Krosno and Warsaw. So thank you, the Lafferty family, that Anya feels like she's with a second family with you. She loves to party with Stephen. And when he's in Krakow, she loves to play with Katie. She loves helping Amanda in arguments. And with Teresa. Now, Jim often gets jealous that Anya actually talks to Mum more than she talks to Jim.
Dziękuję wam wszystkim za przybycie tu dziś, uświetlenie tej ważnej dla państwa młodych chwili, swojej obecności. Życzę wam wspaniałej zabawy aż do samego rana.
So thanks again for all coming here today and honouring this very important moment for the newlyweds and everyone who's present here. And we wish you great fun in the morning.
Anna Green. Życzę wam, by przyjaźń, która była między wami od chwili poznania i która przerodziła się w miłość, przenosząca góry, pokonująca wszelkie przeciwności, pozostała z wami aż do późnej starości. Kiedy młodość wygląd przeminie, pozostanie to co najcenniejsze. Przyjaźń, miłość i troska najbliższą sercu osobę.
100 lat once again. We get it in English first. Last bit, come on, you've been very, very patient. Anya and Jim. Well, we wish that the friendship that was between you from the moment that you met and that turned into love overcomes all the obstacles that face you and remains with you until old age. And when youth and appearance will go away, it will remain with you the most precious things, friendship, love, and caring for the nearest and dearest in your hearts.
start talking. Grab your coat and let's start walking. Come on, come on.
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 Yes. Don't jump the bloody gun.
Thank you. Oblady, oblata, oblata, oblata,
thank you. Michelle. Well done to her.
Oh, this thing, the kind of
swim. I gotta be cool. Thank you.
Back at you, someone that you don't know. That just made your head spin. Before days now, I'm gonna go to a disco in the middle of a town. Everybody's dressing up, I'm dressing down. Her mind's not perfect, but it's sincere. You'd be amazed.